Say yes to new beginnings.
Yes.
Say yes to new standards of excellence.
Yes.
Say yes to engaging reportage with a difference.
Yes.
Introducing Yes International Magazine. The time to say yes to your dreams and aspirations is here.
Whichever way, we land at what
we want to
hear. And journalists must also, I don't know if I can call it education. No quality of good like someone who educates himself with regularity. You don't assume that what you knew yesterday is still relevant today. You may need to improve on it. Don't assume that your subject matter. I've been reporting this bit for 30 years, so I cannot be wrong. You may be wrong. Don't assume that by merely looking at figures, you can tell the entire story. I'll give you an example. Let's say there was a budget in 2016 to build a guest house for the president, 1 billion naira. In 2017, you see the same item in the budget, presidential. Guest house, you see 800 million. In 2018, you see the same thing, presidential guest house, 500 million. You now see that an ad, 1 + 8, 1.8 billion + 5, 2.3 billion. You go to town that they have built presidential guest house for 2.3 billion. You are assuming you know the details. You have not gone the extra mile to know what has happened. It's possible when the first budget was done, they released only 200 million. This year they have added, they have put in the 800 million. So we must keep an open mind. We shouldn't assume we know everything out there. We must constantly educate ourselves.
All right. What makes a good story?
I like a story in which one, whatever you write, news story, feature, opinion, at the end of the day, I've gained something, I've learned something, something that I didn't know before. I like that kind of story. And I like a story that has that attempts to explain beyond he said. A story that tells us more, that puts things in proper perspective, and giving us the details that we need to know.
Okay. What makes a good website?
Well, a good website was a good website, in my own opinion, must be alive, that is constantly updated. If it's news, especially. If I go come to your website in the morning, I see the same thing. I come at 12, I see the same thing. I come in the evening, I'm not likely to be checking that website on a regular basis. So constantly keeping me informed. Even if it is not news, if it is articles, opinions, you know, advisory, whatever it is, I want to be seeing something fresh. And of course, good design. It must be well designed and user friendly.
Alright. Who is a good publisher?
Wow. Well, a good publisher is somebody who, one, is a good mentor, is a good motivator, motivates his team very well, and also rewards performance beyond what is in the contract.
You've been into journalism now for over a decade. Of all the stories you have written so far, because I know you keep writing, so which of them can you describe as your greatest? Of all the stories you have written so far, and why?
Technically speaking, I stopped writing stories probably many years ago.
Okay.
Because I rose to the position of editorship in 2002. That's going to 16 years now. And so technically, even if I write anything, it wants to be
so all of them. Okay, I know.
So, but before, when I was still writing stories,
yes,
and having my
byline,
there was a story I wrote on Rashidi Yekini in 1994 or 95. I call it The Fall of a King. It was flat on the floor in the picture. His career was going in his diving. You know, he had a problem with the wife and all that, and this was always going on. Given the amount of research I did, given the quality of the delivery and the comments I got, in those days there was no social media, I still tend to believe that that is one of the best.
Okay. Written. What would you describe as the greatest lesson that journalism has taught you?
One lesson I have learned from journalism is to be broad-minded, to have a mind that is not narrow. Because why am I saying that? Before I began to see the world more, I had a very narrow perspective, even of Nigeria, of people of Nigeria, of different ethnic groups and all. But by the time I got into journalism, I started traveling around the country. My mind was opened and I sort of began to see things more comprehensively.
Alright, I would like to find out from you. In your career, you must have interviewed dozens of people. Who would you have wanted to interview that you have not been able to interview? Why Obasanjo?
I learned to ask him certain questions.
Okay.
One, when he was going in 2007,
okay,
can he look at me straight in the eye, that when he was speaking, that he had the best interest in the world.
Alright. Now, you write one of the most popular columns in the country today. Of all the things you've written about in your column, which one stands out and why? The one you wrote, maybe something happened, or the one you wrote, even you at the end of the day, you said, yes, I...
This is funny. The article I wrote on Sunday, that Rome was not destroyed.
Okay.
It's one of the best.
And they've been sharing it up right now. I've read to like 30...
It's one of the best.
Okay.
Because of the, why do I call it, consider one of the best? What I like most about it is the fact that I'm challenging people, broaden the way you think, broaden your horizon.
Okay. All right. What do you like most about being a journalist?
The enormous. It's also the. It's what I like is also what I'm not hating the most. Getting to know the story behind the story. things are not where they appear to be. So the access is my is the greatest memory, but now it's depressing me because now I know things that I shouldn't know.
Okay. What is the biggest mistake that most journalists make?
The self-importance. We think we are too much as journalists. Some of us, we actually think we are God.
Okay.
That's too much, the arrogance.
All right. Now, in journalism, you know, some people attain success, but are not able to sustain it. Where do you think they normally miss it? Where do they lose it?
I think we have to consistently reinvent ourselves. Okay. Look at your surrounding. Look at developments. Look at trends. The moment you are you remain frozen in time, you lose it. You lose it.
All right. What actually gave rise to the cable? What actually prompted it? I mean, where you were comfortable, you were doing okay. What?
I used to buy 5 newspapers in a day. Then I noticed that I just wake up in the morning, go on the internet and read all the papers that I needed to read. So when my vendor now stopped me, I'm just like, I think I've read the stories. You just don't know me that increasingly.
What would you say stands the cable out from the other websites in Korea?
Well, let me blow our own trumpet now.
Please go ahead. Like that's what governor would say. How can this actually not blow my trumpet? Didn't I buy it with my money? So please blow
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I think for the cable, well, one thing we are very proud of is the professionalism. We try to be professional. We are not there yet. And being professional means even when you miss it, you accept that you missed it.
Yeah.
And when you get it wrong, you accept it.
Yeah, I remember in one case that you had to fire someone
over a story. And we apologized to the person. Two, the speed and simplicity with which we write our stories. When something happens, we can be sure the next 5 to 10 months it will come. And write in a very simple way, short sentences. I think those things stand us out.
So how does it feel to be the brain behind this popular?
Well, it's good and bad.
Okay.
We have a team that works day and night. The most dedicated team I've ever worked with in my life. Young people, they're working any time of the day. They're working so hard. I'm very happy. I'm very creative. However, you know, people see me as I'm the one doing the work, all the work. So I feel good. But when the abuse is come to me, what's the one I take them on the social media, Twitter, when people be abusing my mother, abusing my father, even when I don't know anything about the story. So that is the downside of it, but I feel very happy when people commend us for the job.
Alright. The name Cable, how did you come up with it? What was the story?
Just like things you read in memory. But the name came about in 2011 or 2012. With WikiLeaks. Diplomatic cable.
Okay.
That's where the
What new trends would you advise that the people who are coming into journalism now and some of those who are already there that they should imbibe?
In as journalists,
yes.
Well, I think they should be able to, they must be ready to read and read and read. They must be ready to learn. They must be ready to read wide. They must be ready to see the best practices all over the world. Take role models and try to see how they do what they do. Before we started the cable, I studied authentic news very well. I studied BBC. .co.uk. I studied CNN.com. So how do they do it? 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 How can we get better and better and better? And we are still studying their own. And so we must be ready to understand the best, how it is done all over the world and how we can do, we can learn from that and apply it for all.
Now it's obvious that journalism has been nice to you. What has journalism not done for you?
What has journalism not done for me?
Yes.
Let's be honest, there's no money in journalism. There's no money in journalism.
Okay.
You can't become a billionaire by being a journalist. You're not a billionaire. But because I have other things that I do, I do printing business, I do, you know, here and there. Even I do some property business. So financially, I can say I'm comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not journalism. Journalism has not given me money. It has not given me money.
Okay, the desire. You know, to go into journalism, what prompted it? What made you?
It's very funny.
Yeah.
It's weird. I wanted to be a lawyer.
Okay.
And along the line, even my form one in secondary school, I was tearing notebooks and writing things and saying I was doing journalism. I was producing weekly reports. But I still wanted to be a lawyer. Then when I collected my job, then I was murdered. For them to kill a journalist, there must be something about this woman. And that's how I filled in journalism into my jam form. It was around the same thing. That's how I filled in. I mean, it's crazy. Why should you want to be a journalist? Where somebody that should send me with, I don't want them to kill me. So that's how I filled journalism into my.
Okay. Other than Delegua, who are the other older journalists, you know, who inspired you or who have rubbed off on you and your career?
The biggest is Ndoka Abaigbena, my chair, the Duke, the Duke. I've never worked with a smarter, innovative person in my life. He thinks and is fit. Impossible is nothing to him. You don't tell him because he can't do something. You tell him there are 10 ways to do it. He doesn't take a no for an answer. He believes that if you know the government, why would you call the press secretary to confirm the story? Why don't you call the government? He's had the biggest influence in my career. But a lot of people have also contributed greatly. Mumine Alao at Complete Football, Victor Ifije, Waziri Adio. Waziri is my contemporary, so I may not be able to mention him without knowing the other guy. And you are Owolo. Great guys.
Okay, most journalists, you know, hardly curate sufficient time, you know, for their families. How do you navigate that?
Luckily, I it's not a problem for me. I spend quite a time with family. I can assure you about that.
So how much of a family man are you?
Well, people say I'm a family man. I don't know if they are just making me feel good.
Okay. Would you like to tell us about your family? Can we meet them?
Yes, if you come to my house, you'll meet them. Yeah, I'm a husband of one wife,
okay.
And I have a daughter.
Okay.
Who is she will kill me if I tell her, I couldn't remember her age. She'll be 16 in 3 months.
What's her name?
Naomi.
Okay, just one.
Okay,
away from journalism, you know, what are the other things that keep you engaged, that make you happy, you know, that you immerse yourself in and maybe you find or you derive joy and satisfaction doing them?
Well, if it's in terms of doing them, I like reading. I like reading academic books to try and understand some intellectual background to some of the things that are happening in the world. I also am involved in a charity. But I won't talk much about that at the right time, but I'm involved in charity. I'm always happy when I see my friends.
Okay, let me take a final question. What's your dream Cape, what's your desire? Where do you hope that you will be, say, in the next, let's say, in the future, not necessarily?
I want the picture we had in mind, the picture I had in mind when I started to play, is that it's going to be the number one in Africa in terms of news website. Along the line, I'm thinking how we belong to a generation where the youth dominate the social media, the internet everywhere, they are everywhere. So how do we bring them into the game? Because they find some of the things we do to be too hard for them. They prefer soft things to be very talking. That's why the most visited websites are not necessarily what they offer
hardcore. The best,
Because some of them offer hardcore porn, you know. But so my dream is that we're going to have a website where there's something for everybody. Something that is legit. So that is my dream. And so if you want to read entertainment news, the first place you want to go to is cable. You want to read on health, the first place you want to go to is cable. You want to read politics, anything. That's so a bigger dream.
How much of that your dream would you say you have accomplished?
Well, in terms of hardcore news, we are almost getting there. We have also set up a lifestyle section that reports on the soft side. We are making progress in that area.
How big is cable in terms of staff strength?
I'm always very bad with that, but I think I roughly would admit. Although we also, I mean, we have a foundation, we share staff in some instances. In terms of core cable, I think we have about 50 of this core, that pure core, what it is, the other school,
all right, thank you very much.
Thanks.